Hallelujah and blessings in Jesus, friends. Welcome back to High Kadosh Ministries, where holiness is a way of life. And Jesus Christ is truly King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And together God's people say, Hallelujah. Well, friends, today is August the 2nd in the year of our Lord, 2017, and this is One a Day for the Soul. Now, our text this morning is going to be taken out of 2 Peter. But before we begin, what I have before me is a box of cereal. And on the side of this box is a list of ingredients. Now, if you were to read these ingredients, what you would find is that the first ingredient listed, which happens to be in this particular box, sugar. It means it contains more of sugar than anything else. The second would be the second most ingredient, the third, all the way down to the last. Now, with this in mind, when we read the lists of the Bible, what we detect is that the pattern is the same. Let me give you an example. In Galatians chapter 5, in verse 22, it tells us the fruit of the Spirit. And the first ingredient is love. Without love, you can't have any of the rest of the ingredients. Love is the primary emotion, state of being within a follower of Jesus. Everything else flows from love. Now, when you get down to the last ingredient listed, that's what is the least important. It doesn't mean that it's not of importance, because if you didn't have it, you wouldn't have a full product. These Frosted Flakes wouldn't taste the same if you took one ingredient out. And so all the ingredients are important, but the first listed is the most important. Well, now understanding that, let us look at our text. We want to begin in verse 4 of chapter 1 of 2 Peter. Now, Peter is opening his letter, and he's identifying Christ. For instance, in verse 2, he says, "Grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord." Verse 3, "According as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness, through the knowledge of him that has called us to glory and virtue." So the subject matter is about Jesus the Christ. Now verse 4, "Whereby," in other words, through Christ, "are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these promises you might be partakers of the divine nature." You might be partakers of the very nature, the very character, the very person of Jesus himself, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust or through evil desires. Just as Jesus lived a life free from those evil desires to lust after the things of this world, so too can we and so too should we. But now look at verse 5. Remembering the ingredients and the pattern laid out. "Beside this, give all diligence, all your effort to faith." That is first and foremost, the main ingredient. From faith comes virtue, which is our lives as seen by others. To virtue, knowledge, which is an investigation into the truth of God. Having accomplished knowledge, temperance, which is a practice of what you have learned through your investigation of God, through studying, investigating his word. Now will come patience, because you have seen the full picture and you know that God is faithful even through the bad times, especially through the bad times. And all these virtues combined will create godliness, which is a life lived pleasing to God. It primarily focuses upon our attitudes, the humility of our hearts. And living a life pleasing to God will produce brotherly kindness. And so I wanted to point that out this morning because of this. You cannot truly help and serve others until you have a heart that is right with God. And that's what these characteristics focus upon. Your personal faith, your personal virtue, your personal knowledge, your personal temperance, your personal patience, your personal godliness. And once that is evident in your life, that will lead to brotherly kindness through the act of self-giving love. And the reason that this is important, because so often we focus upon others, but we give very little attention to ourselves. We see the attitudes that we don't like in others, but what about the attitudes in us? We see the characteristics in others, but what about the characteristics in us? We see how others fall short, but what about how we fall short? You see, we are in a personal, one-on-one relationship with the Savior and King of the world. And He began that relationship so that we could walk, as it stated, in His divine nature. And so we need to not be so quick to point the fingers at others, but we need to put all of our effort, all of our intention into ourselves. And if we do that, friends, we won't have time to worry about anyone else, because there is much uncleanness about us and much work to be done in us. And Jesus, through His Spirit, gives us both the inspiration and the motivation to do what we know needs to be done. But ultimately, we have to be the one to do it. And so I pray today, friends, that you will truly examine your heart, that all your attention will be upon yourself, and that you will do all the work necessary to ensure that you are being molded into His divine character. Now, as He wills, and until tomorrow, friends, I truly love you, and I'll see you on the next video.